The funny thing is, I thought that the whole world and his mother would know the story behind Smoke on the Water. But I still get asked, journalists, people at stage doors, people I meet in the street, when I'm, what is the story behind Smoke on the Water? Was it a mountain burnt down? I mean, what, and you kind of, so you have to tell the story again. But what I love about Smoke on the Water is if you want to know the story, listen to the words. It's a story song. There aren't many narrative story songs in the rock and roll genre, and this is a fine example. And so I would say again, if you want to know what it's all about, just listen to the words.
Just about a couple of years ago now, we were in Montreux in Switzerland recording the Machine Head album. And this song here tells the story of most of the things that happened while we were out there, particularly the burning down of the casino the night we were there watching the show, and all the other affiliated hassles that we had over the period of time that we were there. Smoke on the walls of this one. Yeah.
Oh,
it's interesting the way a band looks at its material when it comes to singles. Because we weren't really, as it goes without saying, we weren't really a singles band. It wasn't the kind of thing that we felt comfortable sort of putting the material into single form. It didn't come easy to us. But we were writing well by that time. And I honestly thought that we'd written a great single in Never Before. In fact, to the point that when we sent it across to Warner Brothers in the States, we sent it with the indication that Never Before would be the single. Came back the comment, "You must be joking. The hit is Smoke on the Water," to which we said, "You must be joking, the hit is Never Before." We honestly didn't think that Smoke on the Water was hit material. How wrong can you be?